help you, sir?
I'm Officer Phelps, miss. I'm here about the shooting. Did you know the victim?
He was my boss. Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage's first name?
Everett.
And you are?
Galleta. Clovis Galleta.
You think you could tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that I'm late on my lunch.
And?
We came back. I was angry. I walked in front. I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
You're lying, Miss Galleta. You know what happened and why. You're going to tell me.
There's nothing to tell. I've done nothing wrong. How can you prove different?
Your pearl earrings, Miss Galleta. You've been paying for them for a whole year. Stop lying. And tell me what happened at the jewelry store.
Oh, God! I won't lose the earrings, will I?
You could lose your freedom, you little fool, if you don't stop obstructing a murder investigation.
Mr. Kalu. Edgar Kalu. He runs the jewelry store. He's showing me a lovely watch. Mr. Gage bursts in. Mr. Kalu gets very angry with Mr. Gage, and they start yelling at each other. Mr. Gage tells me that all of the things in the store are junk, nickel-plated, made in Japan, and yells at me to get back to work.
Then what happened?
We get back here, and I hear a loud bang. Mr. Gage clutches at his back. I hear another bang, and another, and another. Mr. Gage falls to his knees. It looked very painful.
Which jewelry store?
Hartfield's. Broadway, between 5th and 6th.
Did you see the person who shot Mr. Gage?
Of course I did. Mr. Kalu looked very angry. He kept firing the gun. He kept pulling the trigger. He threw the gun in a bin and turned and walked away.
You're making me angry, Miss Galleta. Is that what you want? Tell me why Mr. Kalu shot Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage hates Jews. A lot of people do. It's not my fault if he has nice things. Wait! That isn't everything. You haven't got it all.
Well, yes, apparently this is happening. Due to me having woken up about, 2 hours ago? Yeah, about 2 hours ago. Which is more than I can say for the past few days, but still. Yeah, see, that still says burns in the room. Also, I'm trying to figure out if the OBS preset I'm using to stream right now looks alright, because I have it set to tentatively stream at 60 frames per second, which might seem like a lot, and maybe it is for a stream like this, but with this resolution and all that stuff, but for some reason, if I use any preset apparently other than the ultra-fast preset, which apparently it's supposed to decrease quality the more the faster you want it to go, it looks reasonably or considerably worse, but I haven't really had a chance to confirm that. Also, this game is one of those games that I've had for a long time, but I've been pretty much unwilling to play due to amazing lag. But now I can.
Even minor details can become important later on.
Well, there was one bang. And then another. And then three very quickly close together. Five.
Thank you for your help, ma'am. You've been very brave. We'll need you to make a formal statement about what happened, Mr. Gage.
Does that mean I can still collect my... Never mind. Yes, officer, I'll make a statement.
Alright. Also, from what I do recall, I did play a little bit, like a couple hours of this back when it was all lag, and the way those interrogations work is that you're supposed to figure out what's going on by the witness's facial expression, but sometimes that can be pretty iffy. Intuition points, alright. I don't think I remember that. So, what was I doing? Alright. I guess this. What's something that I've noticed is that the driving is like not really great. Which might be chalked up to the fact that it's trying to be, there it is, like a period piece in the 40s, but but there's another game like this that's pretty much a period piece that I've been trying out, which is Mafia 2, which I can order to do at some point, but I don't think the cars in that handle as bad as the ones in this. Also, I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be Los Angeles, so I guess there's a Broadway in Los Angeles as well. Don't think I've heard about that. Oh boy. Oops.
I hope they didn't get our number, Phelps. Straight on. Turn left up ahead.
Oh, here up ahead. Also, something that kind of irks me a little bit about this is that boy, that braking speed is that even though there is technically a supported way to get this in a window that has the same thing that the Thief games had, where that window is somehow stuck in the middle of the screen, so I can't like move it aside so I can see other windows behind it better, so only see a little of the chat and OBS windows.
What can I do you for?
Officers Phelps and Dunn, sir, Wilshire Division. We need you to trace a serial number.
Sure. What's the make and model?
FN Browning, model 1922. The serial number is 01138.
You don't say. Well, I didn't sell it. Europeans love them, but it's pretty rare you find one over here. Although I did have one in here a couple of weeks back.
Remember the owner?
Yeah. Callu. Edgar Callu was his name. Thing looks like he'd never been fired. He started in here for cleaning anyway. And he bought a box of cartridges and he left.
You know where we can find Mr. Callu?
Told me he was on his lunch break. Said he worked at Hartfield Jewelry Store just up on Broadway.
Thanks for your help.
All right. Broadway, Los Angeles. I guess I have to assume that's a thing. So here we go.
Stay on this one.
Whoa.
Slow down. Turn left when you can.
Oh, this is Broadway.
Interest you in a new watch.
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Callu?
No. Mr. Callu is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go!
Hurry, officer! He's getting away!
Okay. Guess he gets no love from other people. I kinda remember this because this was one of the things that I managed to get done before. Whoa. There we go.
Stop or I will shoot.
Well, you shot up into the air anyway. Pretty sure that's a hazard when you do it way out there. When there are other people around.
That makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solve. The one that keeps you awake at night. The case that gnaws at your guts and ruins your marriage. The case that keeps you propping up a bar as you relive the what-ifs, the might-have-beens, the half-leads, and the half-truths. The case that other cops murmur about whenever you walk past. The case you never, ever discuss.
God's mill may grind slowly, but it grinds finely, son. I hear it's you who knocked down Malefactor from the shooting yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber, a man of initiative. How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
You're asking me to conduct the interview, sir?
I am, young Phelps. You've only been with us a short time, and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record. Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from. But I'm curious as to whether you can turn your hand to interrogation. It takes a certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir. I think I am.
Good man. You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps. A motive, opportunity, hard evidence, and best of all, a confession. If you fail in the former, you can always use a modicum of violence to obtain the latter. How are you feeling, lad?
Fine, sir.
Very good. The evidence is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be eaten by the devil. Bring me a confession, young Phelps. This is your chance. Don't fail me.
Can I remember this interrogation? Have some fairly over-the-top expressions.
Shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
All right. Tell what evidence do we have. Well, we have the gun, which I'm pretty sure we know is his. We have the testimony and... The motive.
followed Everett Gage and the girl back to the shoe store. You put 5 rounds in Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got what was coming. But it had nothing to do with me.
Oh, that face is making, I wonder if he could be lying.
You shot Gage, and we know why. We can put you at the scene.
You can't prove anything.
Yeah, about that.
We know all about the argument. Miss Galetta made a statement.
You're counting on the girl? You think her testimony's gonna stand up in court?
You're going to the gas chamber, Edgar.
That Jew-hating fuck couldn't leave me alone. I had a sale. That girl was ready to buy.
All right.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Cullen?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker. How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well.
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money. And he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I thought that not this sort of thing I would be presenting, but I don't know. Didn't really catch what the voucher was about. Well, what if I back out?
It's nothing personal. I'm just doing my job. You understand that?
I don't know, use intuition. All right. Okay, so it's not lie. Well, I don't know. He does. Pretty nervous, even if it barely shows. What if I picked out? Oh, there we go.
Left wing leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those names, you goddamn goy putt snatcher. You and that stump Gage.
Why did you do it, Mr. Kalu?
Gage. He's in the Chamber of Commerce. He's in with all those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for years.
Edgar Kalu, I'm charging you with the first degree murder of Everett Gage. I respect your beliefs and your right to hold them. I hope for your sake. The jury can commute to murder in the second degree. May God have mercy on you, sir.
Masterfully done, Officer Phelps. It is just Officer Phelps, isn't it, lad?
Yes, sir.
Then let me have a word with the Chief of Police, young Phelps. The department needs heroes. A shining, honest face the public can admire. I applaud a man with your talent for unwavering justice. Back to your duties for now, Boyle. But here's a piece of advice. Get yourself 2 suits, get them pressed. You'll be needing them.
Right.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
Heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine.
I'm here to learn, Detective.
He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earl, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
Now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
that's
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why, you war hero is always so modest. I partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell does it.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside now. I'm gonna start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
Mouthpiece tore strips off me at the grand jury. Case was thrown out. Now the DA.
It's okay.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 months.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Also, they're not really speaking. I don't know if he heard you all the way over there.
Has that just been paid? Look at that, says it's safe.
So I guess this is the car.
You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gas works and signal depot in the warehouse. I'll direct.
It's all right.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? We have to work together. Don't be so touchy. I grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Reno CS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought the Okinawa. Was wounded. Shipped back home. Had a year on the beat. Now I'm here.
Also, where is this police that I'm responding to? All right. Central until service. All right.
So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa. No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready.
Finished?
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Fuck you, Phelps. I earned a brave.
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th.
Oh boy. And I missed it.
Code 2 identified.
11K, go ahead, KGPL.
11K, a 459 suspect just
oh boy.
6th in Sarah. Suspect is a male Caucasian, believed to still be in the area. Code 2.
All right, well, here we are.
Up on the roof, officer. He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
up now. Make it easy on yourself.
Oh, okay, I was wondering where the guy went, and I still am. Oh, there's a pipe there, isn't there? I wish I had noticed that sooner. Oh. Climbing that hole is no problem. And apparently I can't do the stop or else shoot thing with this guy. Oh boy.
Now, are we gonna make a bargain or what? How long do you think you can hold out? On your own goddamn head,
be it. Well, alright, that didn't go so well.
All units of 459 just occurred in 6th
and 7th. Well, fortunately, looks like we're pretty much right up here already.
He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
Well, let's try this again. Well, this game does give me a mafia-ish vibe, but with cops. And I understand that a lot of people were playing it when it first came out.
Let's negotiate.
Put the weapon down now.
All right. How about this time? All right. I guess get a better chance of doing this on his like that. That's when their heads are right next to each other. Well, I guess that was technically a detour. Oh boy, music. Can't remember if I heard that before, but... Oh boy.
Oops. Siren.
So just what? I don't remember how to use the siren, actually. Was it one of the number buttons? I don't think it was. Oh, okay, it's not O. Okay, might as well just check. H. Do we even have a siren in this car, though? Yeah, I guess we do.
Bukowski! Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stuck. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
Well, time to look into stuff again, I suppose. Investigation music.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped a full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Intuition, discharge, or clues? Do we even have any of that right now? I think it's easier if we just look around the old-fashioned way right now.
I don't think so.
Well, I guess we can't even check out this thing. Thoroughly because it's deemed irrelevant. Well, what about this thing right here? That's labeled as evidence. It's got the blood all over it.
Brand name might give us something to go on.
Or maybe not. Wouldn't really assume that would be the case, but I guess gotta have everything in mind. Well, that said something like C on the indicator. So what about A and B? Are they near the car? Oh, there's a B. I guess the car itself is B.
The victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
The victim looks to have exploded inside the car. Oops. Well, what about the fuel tank? I'm guessing that's a fuel tank. I guess not. No.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
Do you say that because of the big tape on the bridge?
Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here?
Well, I take it that's the guy.
Happier times, I guess.
Apparently we're looking for Drew Carey. But we don't know where he is. Well, what about the witness? Well, I guess we're gonna open the trunk first. Never mind.
No good to me.
Generic. No brand name or anything, so I guess no good.
Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday?
Did F. Morgan also put a bunch of cops on a train and leave them for dead? did he hide behind a curtain? Oh well, we can't check this thing in front. The hood, I guess that's what I was looking for, that word. Oh, what does this guy have to say?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. The victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Yeah, pretty sure there's no sign of him in the case.
Sir,
oh, what about you?
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
All right.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Well, I see no reason to doubt this, so...
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Well, about the suspect. We can observe the suspect as well, I guess. It looks like he has something he might want to say, but...
You know, my nephew joined the police. And he's a little slow, too.
That's nice.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
Well, I doubt we can prove that if he's lying, but... Doesn't look like he is. So let's go with him on that.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
Yeah, about that bloodstained pipe. Oh, whoops. No, what I wanted to do was review the evidence. It does have, Insta-Heat brand. I just wanted to review that and keep that in mind.
Blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
See, this seems like the kind of thing that it would be plausible he would lie about, but I guess it's not.
Saw the blood. Was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Contents of the wallet. I guess he also didn't go for the wallet.
Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
See, now he looks nervous. Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure he did take a look. But, well, what do we know about the wallet? Well, it did have his information, and it had a picture, but it had no money in it, you see. So it's either a doubt or a lie, but I'm not sure which, because I don't know if he'd be able to prove there was any money in it to begin with that he might have stolen. How can you say no to that face, though? No, I'll try a lie.
Tell the truth, Mr. Wilkie. You rifled the wallet.
My money is my money. You can't prove I touched that wallet.
Gee, I'm afraid he's right, is the thing. Can't prove he touched it. So I guess we'll have to go with doubt instead.
Looks like I was mistaken.
There we go.
I want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie.
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
Alright, talk to whom right now, though?
Notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
Alright, we'll take your word for it. Hold E to make your power drive. I guess we're taking the same car we drove in on, but I don't know how fast is he willing to drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
Well, the residence. It's the place we haven't gone, so. So I guess that's like a fast forward thing. I guess that's a reason to choose that, and also the fact that it minimizes the risk of me hitting a pedestrian. Which is always a very real possibility.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. Oh, we can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name InstaHeat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
All right. Okay, I heard that sound. What did I miss? Apparently this. Then why did the little mystery note play? Well, whatever. It's the same thing, wasn't it? Oh well. Little model airplane. Why are you messing with that?
I doubt it.
Alienist Fontaine. Story behind the headline.
Lie down, make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's.
Yes, Doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions. These blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey. A journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
Well, that guy looks trustworthy. Newspaper collected. Oh boy. Guessing that means not just for this case. Now what? It's not the newspaper, is it? Nope. What do we got? Kavanaugh's.
So who brought this home?
Not Terry Kavanaugh, surely. That guy's kind of overrated.
I should have an address.
Telephone or game oil? Alright, I guess we're gonna use this person's phone. Without asking permission.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt. South side of Union Station.
Thanks.
So I guess that's one more thing collected. And I would like to assume that that's out of the way. Now what? Oxidol, oh boy.
Don't think this is anything.
What's it for, though? What? Oh, soap. Rather soup for a moment. What about this thing on the right or the left?
This doesn't pertain to the case.
And yet we can select both of those things. Phelps, are you stuck? Looks like you were for a moment there. Can't look in the trash can or anything. Well, hey. Wilshire, well. 10-year warranty. I guess that was pretty good for a heater. In the 40s. Now what about this thing on the right? Guess we're leaving a receipt on the kitchen table.
Maybe the paid around outside.
Paid by a name I can't really read. I guess we're looking outside now. No way. But we're not going to remark on the red and blue flowers. Also, I see that frame rate dip.
No use leaving the thing half finished.
And yet they did. Oh boy, time to do some puzzling.
That can't be right.
Can't be right. Well, I'm pretty sure, okay, I was gonna say I don't see any other way, but then I saw the other side. So, one of the pieces is missing, and I'm gonna guess that it is the one that we found over at the crime scene.
So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
Yep, it would certainly seem that way. Well, I'm guessing we shouldn't leave the home just yet, but
nothing significant.
Nothing significant other than, you know, people could just come up here and steal that if he just leaves it out like that. And maybe use that for a murder weapon. Well, we could leave, but I'm not sure that we're done here quite yet. I think we skipped a couple of rooms. Now what about the shed in the back? Can we do anything here? I guess we cannot. And I'm forced to assume that this is also this. Well, back inside we go, I guess. Because I didn't see what was on this side. Get a glasses case. And I'm guessing that if we open this up, there's gonna be no glasses because we have them.
Stencil. So the glasses are a match.
Yep, there's a picture, but we can apparently further investigate that by. Oh boy.
To my Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting.
Well, that's one half of that investigator, I guess.
A used ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house.
Suitcase gone missing. How do you know that that's the case? Maybe they just like to arrange their suitcases like that? I would hardly call that evidence. This is purely circumstantial, you see. Can I open this door? I cannot. Can we examine anything over on this side? Well, apparently we can examine this picture even though they didn't play the sound.
Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here?
And this one we cannot investigate further, it looks like. Then apparently even though they're husband and wife, they have separate bedrooms. Well, can we talk to the wife again? That might yield something. I guess. Boy, I got a bunch of stuff to go through. And she's got the same face.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan.
Of course.
That's what he's up to.
Well, I hear he does some wonderful things sometimes. But sometimes he... Oh boy. Can I review the statement? Kind of, I'm wondering what I'm trying to call her out on, if I am. She does look kind of restless. Where was the receipt for the hog? This one. Signed by Frank Morgan. Well, can we hear more about Frank Morgan?
The situation doesn't look good, Margaret. You need to tell me what you know.
If that person does in fact exist.
I'm also a victim.
Okay, I guess that didn't go as well as it could have. What about this?
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian protected me there after work.
Well, what do we know about the bar? She does look like she's might not be telling everything. Don't think we have any more information on that though. Well, the situation. tell the truth or lie. I guess truth.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there.
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
Well, I guess that's her normal state right now.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was going to meet Frank for a drink.
She always looks off to the side like that, but partly that's the case even when she's not lying. I could swear though that she looks a bit more antsy than the other times this time. What if we doubt?
So you didn't arrange to meet him out at the rail yard?
Oh boy.
I've never been near a rail yard in my life.
Didn't think that would take that direction. It's okay.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Well, if she does the exact same expression as before, I guess I'm forced to assume that it's the truth. Even if she's shaking her head like that and looking off to the side, I guess it's the truth.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
Okay, I'm pretty sure that she's gonna be lying on at least one account, though. It's just a matter of finding it.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Let's go and look to the right and shake your head. Yep, there we go. Truth.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
Yeah, I have the feeling, yeah, that this is gonna be the one where... Well, I was gonna say that the one where she's hiding something, but she's doing the same stuff as in other times. So, well, we can prove, I guess, that... But that's not all that that is, but... It could be an... Oops. An unconscious lie. Does it still count as a lie?
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
Well, I see no reason to doubt that, but... But the fact remains that this is a thing.
What about...
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
Well, this was kind of tricky, given that there was barely any visual feedback that could indicate whether or not she was lying. It was pretty much all a matter of being aware of the evidence. So I guess we're going to the bar now. The question is, though, how far away is it? Because if it's not that far away, I might do the driving, because why not? Oh boy. It's a bit far away, but it looks like it's just a couple of turns. Oh, you know what? Why not?
Watch what you're doing!
Well, it's not my fault. I'm trying to go off into these.
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. Stranger things have happened.
Oh boy. Okay, I guess if you do the insta-warp thing, you can't respond to these things. Totally think about that. Well, how away is this? Okay, that's where I am. I forgot that I have to use the mouse. It's quite a ways away, but I keep going straight down until I get to 8th, and I should be a straightforward thing. Discovered landmark, what? Alright. I'm not quite sure what the purpose of the landmarks is just yet, but...
KTI is a member of the American Century Broadcasting Network.
Oh yeah, we have a siren, don't we? We kind of, would be... entitled to have that on right now, since we're on the way to a crime scene that's in progress right now. Here yet, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Just in case. I have a feeling the answer was just right. Oh boy.
Kid, drop that money one more time and you're a goner.
Sorry, mister. It's just my hands are shaking.
Shut up! Get the money in the bag!
Yes. Yes, sir.
Hurry the hell up, will you? Come on. It's goddamn cops!
Careful! He's got a gun!
Oh boy. Oh, I thought it was just gonna be a covert gunfight thing, just like before, but I guess not in this occasion. Oh boy. Can we lift the car? Yeah, I guess we can. Only police cars or radio dispatches, however, but we can't really be picky about that right now. Whoa. I think that is a fast car. Whoa. So where's he gone off to? Is that the guy? Or am I supposed to get out of the car? Oh, I guess he's out of the car, so... Just following this guy. Because if this guy wasn't around to show me where I'm supposed to put it, then I'd be very disoriented. Okay. Where? Well, apparently he got his hat shut off, but apparently we're fine.
Car 11K to KGPL. Bristol Hotel 211 is code 4.
Please be advised, code 4 at the Bristol Hotel on 8th Street, code 4.
Okay. Outfits have been unlocked, I suppose. Sort of justice outfit, oh boy. And now back to the case at hand. Oh. Well, it's not my fault if the traffic is ridiculous. And they forced me to do stuff like that. So where am I now? There I am. I don't know what this is, so this is police station. So how do I get back on track now? I'm on Olive, and if I get to whichever one this is, and turn right, then I should be not too far. It's past first and the one after that one. And apparently it stops or marks the end of this one, so can hard to miss. Okay, now where am I going? There I am, and okay, turn right, then left, and then right again, and go straight, I suppose. Saying that, but I guess it's too late now, never mind. Wanted to know where on the map that was, but I guess it's too late now. Well, we made it to the bar. It failed to notice that it was on the right side, but
the bar.
Hey,
key.
I know you.
No, you don't.
Oh,
my acting coach says I have real talent.
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's a regular. He's a loner in the back. She wants a five-star goddamn wedding.
All right. Well, which one? I mean, oh, well, that was easy.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Oh.
All right.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Now, please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk off, Phelps.
Well, I really don't know what to make about that. That bugle face is making. Well, I mean, the only evidence we have that directly links to him is the ticket for the pig. It was found in the car, so I guess we can't bring that up.
You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
Well, we do have this. We don't have anything else, but
you were there, Morgan. We
We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you.
All right, already. That fool Adrian's fallen for some dame in Seattle.
Well, why didn't you just say that?
It looked like he'd been attacked.
Well, if you're coming clean about that, then.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
Well, he's not making the bugle face anymore, but. Okay, we can't exactly call him out on that, so I guess we have to go with it.
How was he getting there?
I don't know. Maybe a Greyhound? You guys ought to go try the terminal on Sunset.
Well, we do have a ticket. But apparently that wasn't the right thing. I guess he was hiding his fingers, I don't know. Oh yeah, I guess he was. Guess he's got his hands on the table otherwise.
So Adrian isn't hurt? What's with all the blood?
I don't know. It was dark. He must have caught a nick on something. Yeah.
Yeah, that would have caused him to explode. Okay, I'm pretty sure he's lying. But how do I call him out on that? Or can I not? Large splashes of blood. What if he was at the yard? He can't. He can't very well. Deny that there were giant splotches of blood all over the car. Well, we have two intuitions, so it's one of the one or the other, I believe. Well, it's obviously not truth, but goddammit. That doesn't help. So that was a wasted point. Guess we can't disprove that it was dark.
Aiding and abetting a criminal conspiracy. Do you want me to come up with some other charges, Morgan?
We bought a small hog and put it in the trunk. We got to the rail yard. I cut the pig's throat and drained the blood into a bucket. Splashed the blood all around the car. Adrian hit the pig a couple of times with the pipe to make the pipe look convincing.
This doesn't happen. Well, I guess I did get him on that.
Excuses don't help. Let's see how you enjoy the LAPD taking an interest in your life.
You want my opinion? Lutale Morgan. I say he's lying, and whatever hole he's got Adrian stashed in, he's got to go back there sometime.
What's he doing? Why would he go and leave like that right after he talked to the police and without making sure that they aren't gone yet?
He sure left his drink in a hurry. I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
Lex to focus the camera on the subject. Well, that doesn't really help because it makes it kind of difficult to see the road ahead of me. So I guess no one in Los Angeles respects.
Now would be a bad time to forget how to drive, Cole.
Well, I can't help it if this guy stops suddenly. That's terrible driving practice. That endangers everyone. I can't really tell which one he is. I guess he was the first in line there. Of all the cars that were turning right. Alright, where is the suspect's car? Is it ahead? Yeah, it's way ahead. I didn't notice. Also, hello, Zero. Oh. Just need to get a little closer.
Better back it off.
But not too close, huh? Really can't be close at all, it seems. I guess I just guide myself by the icon on the map.
Where are you taking us, Mr. Morgan?
Okay, that's not him, the one that stopped. It's kind of hard to tell sometimes. Where is he? Is he the one with the light that's turning? What? No, he's the one that stopped. I guess he was that guy. Oh yeah, what time is it? It's like almost 6 for me because daylight savings time ended yesterday. If it hadn't, then it would be almost 7, but it's almost 6.
Day one of the big time, and you're already tailing drunks home from bars.
Well, I woke up how many hours ago? Like 3 or 4 hours ago now. Which makes sense since I fell asleep like an hour into my stream yesterday. And that is technically a lot better than all the days that preceded that, where I had woken up at like the same hour that I fell asleep. Also, we're looking for Morgan, so.
Apartment 2.
Apartment 2.
Alright, let's pay our friend a visit, see if he's missed us yet.
Apartment 2 would be... I can't really see the numbers. This is kind of very poorly lit, but there it is.
Who the hell is that?
Oh boy.
Max? Jesus, Adrian, I told you, we're in the clear. I'll get it. Ah, shit.
Who could have expected that?
It's over, Morgan. Mr. Black? LAPD, give yourself up now!
Well, the guy didn't do anything. I mean, he was just trying to have an affair. But I guess we're still... bring him in for wasting police time.
There's no point running, Adrian.
I really don't understand why he's running away like this for that reason.
Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian. Stop right there, Adrian.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
Why, though? Is it really doing him for wasting police resources?
That turned out to be quite some case, huh? Adrian. What an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you could go a long way in this department.
Okay, we're not gonna question that, I guess. Well, I missed a clue, apparently, along the way. But Morgan would have rolled over in Adrian Black with that, with some tougher questioning. Well, I only missed one of the three questions on his interrogation, so... it's kind of hard to tell what their expressions are supposed to mean the first time. Also, I'm pretty sure that's the last thing I did the first time I played this game, so... time to go into Uncharted territory.
Keep this short, I'm already late for the DA. First up, Phelps, Bukowski, we got a report of a brand new Packard abandoning an empty lot off 2nd Street between Olive and Grand. DR is one Oswald Jacobs, says the vehicle was dumped in his backyard. There's a patrolman on site, get down there and see what you can turn up. Any questions? Good, get going.
Hey, there's such a thing as soap, you know.
Better go earn our pathetic wages.
Okay.
Rimsky, O'Halloran. Intelligence has information on a stolen car wreck.
An abandoned vehicle. Catch all the good ones, huh, folks?
Sounds like there's more to it than that. Nobody dumps a shiny new Packard unless they borrowed it without asking.
You don't say. You're on fire today, Einstein.
Very funny.
Come on, my intense protege.
Okay. I get the feeling that if I drive the normal way, one of those spur of the moment radio kisses is going to come in. But in the meantime, oh boy.
Seattle threw him out. Wife says she's gonna take him back.
Women generally show more compassion. What are you talking about? Adrian dumped on her. He was humping the secretary. Margaret should show some pride. Pride comes before a fall.
Well, apparently the place is just a couple blocks away. Never mind.
Phelps, traffic.
I'm Officer Houlihan. Cars down the alleyway, detectives.
We got a call about an abandoned vehicle?
Yes, sir. The car has flags. Might be some kind of diplomatic vehicle.
Has anyone touched this vehicle since you arrived?
No. And that Jacobs bird over there was on station before I got here.
We'll talk with him in a moment. Give us some time to look the place over.
Sure, take your time. He's a sore-headed old son of a bitch anyway.
So, time to get all investigative again. How many of these little labels we got? Apparently the plate was taken off.
We'll have to use the registration to trace the owner.
And the tires, where at least one of them was.
Stealing the wheels is for amateurs. Car ring would have stripped it in a warehouse.
Right, I'm trying to back off, but apparently, oh boy. Is that the Argentinian flag? Why? But only one of them. Yeah, apparently they just took one wheel. That say license fee received, Consulate General of Argentina in the 40s. What were those guys doing in the 40s anyway? Don't know anything about the history of Argentina, but didn't they have that Perón guy around this time, or was that before? Well, apparently there's nothing in the trunk. We're not gonna check that little toolbox even. Are there any more clues around that we can find? Can we remark on the tire marks? No, but apparently we can find this that I didn't even see before. I guess we're not going to deem that as relevant. Also, right now it looks like, well, right now and during some of the cutscenes I've seen, it looks like the OBS frame rate fluctuates, like one moment it's in the 40s and then it goes down to like 12. Oh boy, what do we got?
Combination wrench. Must have used it to remove the wheel lugs.
Sucker. Well, I know that's where that Maradona guy comes from, but I pretty much don't know anything about soccer or any sports beyond anecdotal stuffs. Nope, but we're just going to leave this dirty bat that was at the crime scene, or suspicion scene, I'm not sure what to call it at this point. We're just going to ignore that. Okay, whatever you say. Guess you would ignore this though. This, is that a paper cup?
Doesn't give me anything to go on.
And a baseball. Anything here near these bushes? Oh boy. Well, we can break that crate some more. Guess we're not going to consider that as tampering with the evidence or the crime scene. about these hanging clothes here? Don't we consider these suspicious? Oh boy. Look at these physics. That's why you gotta get the Nvidia card so you can do that. Oh, that's a game wheel. I was wondering what the meaning of that was, but I'm pretty sure I have no reason to do that right now. Do you have anything to say? Can I even speak to you? I guess not. Now what about this guy right here?
That's right.
What exactly happened here, Mr. Jacobs?
Last night, I was looking out of my window. I like to keep an eye on what's going on.
I can understand that.
You see this empty lot? Damn kids play stickball here. Always breaking my windows. Always asking for their ball back.
Can we get back to the car, Mr. Jacobs?
Don't be impatient, Sonny. Anyway, last night I see this brand spanking new Packard up on bricks.
All right.
Did you see who stole the Packard?
Hell yes, I did. I saw three goddamn Mexicans going to work on it.
Those goddamn Mexicans. Well, I guess he must have.
Can you tell us what they were doing?
Using the headlights of an old Ford so they could strip the thing. I yelled out to them, I'll call the cops. So they loaded up their car and drove off, tooting and hollering and yelling obscenities at me in Mexican.
You speak in Spanish? Mexican? Oh, boy.
No, I do not.
I bet he speaks American, though. So, let's see. Oh, he does look vaguely like Eastwood. With those deep wrinkles in his brow.
After the Mexicans left, you didn't go anywhere near the car?
After I scared him off? No, I didn't go anywhere near that car.
Didn't go anywhere near the car, yeah. I don't think that's the case. Of course, I also don't think we can do anything to disprove that. Because there's stuff missing from the car, but I think there's a link to him in particular.
You went out to the car. Once they were gone, you had to take a look for yourself.
I was curious. Ain't a law against that. So what if I took a look around that car? You can't be accusing me of nothing.
So he did go near the car, but is that it or did he take something?
Tell me about the car they were driving.
It was an old Ford. I didn't catch the license number.
Okay. He recognized the make, though, apparently. So sure, let's go with him on that.
You look like the kind of guy who notices details.
You're right there. The car was old, but it looked brand new. Candy apple red paint job stands out a mile.
Alright, so far so good.
What exactly did you see them take?
They was working on the tires. That's all that was took.
Yeah, that's not all that was missing though. And we do have some evidence for that, like the license plates and the flag, but... well, we could use either of those, I guess.
Why did you take the license plate?
Me? Well, what'd I do with license plates? You saying I have them?
I guess we have to pick that. Well, I don't know that you have them, but we know that they're not there.
Scratching around in that book won't prove nothing. You should show me some respect.
I guess not.
Help, Mr. Jacobs. You can speak to Officer Thibault about signing a formal statement.
When you get the car out of the way, maybe you could come back and do something about those kids.
How about we bring you an umpire's mask? Jacobs dumped the book he was reading in a hurry when we walked up. Curious what he wants to see?
Well, not quite sure how we would have gone about linking him to the missing plates, but guess I was missing that. So let's see what this is at any rate. 1947. Oh boy. Juan Francisco Valdez.
Anderson by R&I.
I'm sorry, what? How did you determine that by looking at the notebook?
Contact details on a William Dewey. This looks like business rather than pleasure.
I guess none of the other one having details like this? No. Oh boy.
I think we've wrung this place dry. Let's find a game well.
I don't know where that guy has a notebook like that lying around, but I had the feeling we're going to find out.
Phelps, badge 1247. Could you run the name Dewey Brothers? Possibly a dealership or car mechanic workshop.
One moment. Dewey Brothers Packard Dealership, 629 Figueroa Street.
Got it. Can you put me through to Michigan 2458, please?
Connecting you now.
Hello, can I help you?
LAPD, ma'am. Can I speak to John Madsen, please?
He's at school, officer. What's this about? Is he in trouble?
How old is your boy, ma'am?
Just turned 16.
Wrong person, Mrs. Madsen. Sorry to disturb you.
Oh, boy.
Messages, please.
There's just one message for you, detective. A four-door Packard, diplomatic license number, Paul Robert 706. Was reported missing this morning by Juan Francisco Valdez.
Could you have him brought in?
He's already here at Central, Detective. He's demanding an audience, as he calls it.
Thanks. Can you get a message to Captain Leary? Tell him we'll be in as soon as we can. Thanks, ma'am.
All right, I guess.
Hold off this lot until we have the vehicle impounded.
Yes, sir, Detective.
Guess we're going back to the station then.
Get a statement from Jacobs, and I'll read your report back to the station.
We can visit the Packard dealership or head back to Central and interview this Valdez character. Your call.
Well, I think I would rather have some more information before I speak to anyone. And I still haven't gotten any of those random calls. So let's try going to the dealership first. So the guy's already in the car? Yeah, I guess he is.
Here's a novel idea. Turn on the siren.
Okay, fine. We're turning on the siren even though we're
this has gotta be the 50th abandoned vehicle.
Not doing anything urgent right now.
I'm gonna go crazy. Not your favorite cases? You kidding me? This is barely even police work. Of all the bad guys in this city, we get lumped with the ones who can't even be bothered to keep what they steal.
Ah, here we go. See, I was waiting for one of those things to appear, so now that it has, I want to find out where or how far I need to go now to get to that place. Go right back to that place that I just came from and keep driving down, I suppose. So left then right again. Oh. And at least now it is justified to have the siren on. Whoa, okay, I did not realize that was there. But at least we're still alive. So let's do this.
Hey, GPL,
these places have so much preparation, H? Ooh-wee! Benny's giving speed!
No way, we got another chase here, I bet. I'm kind of wondering how. Oh boy, getting out of construction site. Can I can't do the stop rock shooting a bit. Just keep climbing until we can't climb no more a bit. Or, oh boy, well, we do seem to be at a stalemate here. Oh boy. Oh yeah, I need to hold down the right button the entire time, I forgot about that. So that was another street crime complete. And we get one more intuition point. I guess we get to spend those. Good job.
We try to get there in one piece?
Well, I would, but I can't help it when other cops can't do their job right. See, I'm not the only one. Oh. Well, maybe this will help everyone get out of my way. Or get in my way, or two. Okay, I'm forgetting what the map thing is. So where am I going? Oh, there I am going. Just get to 6 and turn right in there. Oops. Is this the one I have turned right on? Yeah, it is. Can't really see the names of the streets that well on the minimap. It just says street, and then all the way over here it's a 6th. Oh boy, I've just discovered a landmark, have I? Pershing Square. Even though I already passed through there when I was pursuing that Jew guy. So why did you stop?
Christ alive!
Why does the traffic in this game have the same troubles as the traffic in real life?
Past the lot, caught sight of the new model four-door and couldn't help yourself. You could see yourself in that car and just had to take a closer look. Well, I can't say as I blame you.
LAPD, Mac. We'd like to speak with the owner.
That's me, William Dewey, proprietor at your service.
We're investigating the theft of a Packard belonging to the Argentine embassy. Are you missing a combination wrench?
I don't know, detective, but I know how we can find out. Follow me.
Oh boy. Well, as long as he doesn't try anything funny. Then again, I don't see what his justification for that would be, just in case, or so far.
You sure you guys aren't interested in a new car? Huh? Maybe a used car. I have some nice used cars for guys in your wage bracket.
Could this be the one? No, I guess not. 3/4. There we go. So yeah, either one of the red ones or one of the yellow ones is gonna be missing. I'm guessing it's gonna be one of the red ones, yeah. It's shaping up to be like that.
One left.
I mean, you don't have to put it in place to observe which one is going to be the missing one. Also, Delgado. I'm pretty sure Delgado is one word. It means thin in Spanish. Delgado, two words would be of the gado, but gado doesn't mean anything. Okay, so we're missing one wrench. Can we talk to anyone around here or find anything else? Oh wait. Well, we can take a look at this, but I see no reason to.
Doesn't look like anything.
I'm pretty sure that is something, considering that we're, you know, the guy that's working on the car. He's presumably going to need it, but. Oh wait, what about this?
This isn't what we want.
Well, can we talk to the honest dealership owner again? Does he have anything else to say?
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
Yeah, I guess we do.
Packards are great cars, but this doesn't look like the kind of place favored by foreign embassies. How do you know Valdez?
I don't know Valdez. The embassy bought the car. All I know is he must know a quality car when he sees one.
All right. A John Goodman scowl. But beyond that, so he says he doesn't know that guy. Phone number for William Dewey. Well, he does seem to have this guy's phone number, so. Whoops. So I get the feeling we could bring that up as, well, might as well use intuition. It's a lie.
And I know a shyster when I see one. You and Valdez are in this together.
Me and Valdez? I hardly know him. Valdez wouldn't wipe his shoes with me.
Well, you say you don't know him, but you see. Oh, it actually removes some of the evidence you can use as well. It's nice.
We found your contact details in Valdez's notebook. He had to be calling you for something, Dewey.
Okay. So I met Valdez in a bar. We cut a deal and he bought the car through the embassy. I cut him some change on the side. It happens all the time.
Whereabouts of Delgado?
Where can we find Delgado?
I don't know. Sure as hell isn't here.
Well, we don't know anything about him in the evidence, but it's pretty obvious that that's not the case.
Address, Dewey, or my partner shoves her head in a car door.
Yeah, that'll work.
Hey, all right. Apartment 3103 Hill Street. And tell him from me, if he ever shows his face around here again, I'm gonna kick his butt from here to Kingdom Come.
Right, last question for now.
A wrench from this dealership was used to strip the wheels from a Packard last night, Mr. Dewey. A couple of Hispanics were seen taking parts.
We've had a spate of thefts ourselves. Comes with the location. Thieving bastards will steal anything the minute your back is turned.
So his argument is that it was stolen, and well, he's making that scowl and kind of squinting every so often, but I don't think we have anything to suggest that he wouldn't know anything else. So I guess the wrench would have been stolen.
Said, the workshop's too close to the street. It's difficult to keep an eye on it.
No, I guess not.
No problem. God damn that kid. I'm just an honest car salesman. Seems like you just don't know who you can trust these days.
Going to movies, Dewey. You're missing your calling. Time to visit Gabriel Delgado. See how good his excuse is.
So I guess the other option was removed. Can't go back to the central station. I mean, that's kind of close to where we came from. And apparently the guy that met the dealership guy. Actually, hang on a minute. Can I convince the guy to drive so that we can get there faster?
You read this story in the Examiner about the Navy developing three-dimensional movies? What's a dimension? You know, like a graph. Vertical axis is Y and horizontal is X. Well, that's clear as mud. Third dimension would be Z. So things would be popping out of the screen. That's ridiculous. Scare people out of the theater. God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talkies in color. Look what we have now.
Well, I guess I haven't heard about that train arriving at the station film.
Do we have a Juan Francisco Valdez in for questioning?
Sure do, Phelps. Your bird's an interview too. And get this, he's wearing gloves and doing his best not to touch anything. Can you beat that?
Sounds like we don't want to keep this guy waiting. It's this way.
Okay. Well, we already interviewed the car dealership guy, so...
About time. Are you the senior officer I requested?
God.
I'm Detective Phelps, and this is Detective Bukowski.
Have you any idea how long I've been waiting to speak with you? I am needed back at the consulate, and you keep me here like a common criminal.
Well, right, you're the one who decided to show up, I mean.
Start all over again. Mr. Valdez.
Counselor General. I insist on my full title.
Of course you do. So let's get talking, I guess.
Where did you purchase the car?
My secretary and driver arranged the purchase. A disreputable place, a Dewey Brothers by name.
So you don't like him.
I will have my Hispano Suiza brought up from Buenos Aires.
It's okay. Well, he did buy the car from that place. I mean, we already kind of confirmed it, but kind of looks like there might be something else to go on. He's not telling the whole truth. The abandoned vehicle is registered to the consulate. I guess we don't know yet that he bought it through the consulate, or we're not supposed to know. Okay, use this. Okay, I guess it's gotta be Doubt.
Bought a Packard, Valdez? A snob like you doesn't drive an American car. I want answers or I'll smack you around the teeth.
Of course.
William Dewey offered me a substantial bribe to make a purchase at his establishment. It is not unusual to make this kind of transaction in the civil service.
Don't tell that to the Argentine taxpayers. Consul General, we have located your car. Can you tell us how it was stolen?
It must have been stolen from the consul garage. Terribly inconvenient, of course. I want the perpetrator soundly flogged.
Unfortunately, we don't do that here, Your Worship.
And they do in Argentina? I mean, I don't know what they did during the... whole dictatorship period, but well, do we have anything to prove that he might be lying about it having been stolen from the garage? Because apparently, well, maybe the stolen wrench could be connected to that, but registration, the stuff that was missing, and dumped in the empty lot. Well, I see. I'm pretty sure he would be telling the truth if he wasn't doing those weird faces and looking off to the side, but...
You, senor, remind me of my cousin Jose, who was kicked in the head by a polo pony. We shot the pony, but we probably should have shot poor Jose instead.
Okay. I think I'm gonna go with doubt. Also, I keep forgetting that I have to use right button to go back instead of escape.
You have a pretty good idea, don't you, Consul General? Are you gonna tell me, or do I shake it out of you?
There's no call for violence. I suspect a disgruntled boy from the car dealership.
You have a name for this kid?
Gabriel, like the Archangel. I have no surname.
And, of course, that made one more question appear.
So tell us about this kid, Gabriel. You had a run-in with him?
Mecánico. A presumptuous young man who did not know his place. He presumed to ask me questions.
But we do a lot of presuming here in the United States, Consul General. It comes with the turf.
Okay. So he's a mechanic, and, well, he's having his hand, so that makes it kind of obvious that... Something else is happening. But I see no obvious connection between the evidence and that. Oh, Gabriel, I forgot about that. Well, there's a stolen wrench, but apparently it belonged to that guy. If anything, I would say that that corroborates the story that this guy tells, but I guess we have to bring it up.
You fuck young boys, Valdez.
Oh boy.
Are you a madman? This will cause an international incident.
Well, I mean, we have his name in the notebook, which kind of looked like that was what it was. It kind of did look like this was the direction it was heading, but I guess we can't... We can't bring that aspect up because we don't have that kind of foresight. I have a feeling it might have been not such a good idea to come here right after all, but...
Attention!
What? What? Okay, I guess I'll bring this up.
When I leave here,
oh boy.
I will seek legal advice from my government, detective. Then, I will bring your police department to its knees.
Okay, so that wasn't right, Lion. General.
Let's nail this kid Delgado and wrap this thing up.
Why do I get the feeling that we should have gone to the kid before we came here? Oh well.
Finished with Valdez.
Thank God. I'll get rid of him in a couple of hours.
Well, there's only one place left to go now.
You know the way. You can drive. Where are we going?
Well, we're going to the kid's house. Let's see if we can get to the end of this story.
Okay, let's see what Gabriel has to say for himself.
Let's hope our Archangel hasn't already flown.
Isn't that the cop who solved the big case and got promoted?
Well, they wouldn't happen to be here. Wouldn't happen to be one of these. One of these people. Or maybe not, I guess. Check this out. Just let yourself in. Oh, but it's like an apartment house. Oh. No, I guess it's just a regular house, but I guess this is the right place.
Here he is. Apartment 3.
Nope, never mind, it is an apartment house. But it doesn't have a mailbox, so they just leave the letters out there. That's nice. Here we go.
Yes?
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Gabriel Delgado.
Gabriel?
We're from the police. Policia, you understand?
Yes, God. I understand. Could you come inside?
What is your name?
Ana Rodriguez.
Is Gabriel Delgado here, Ms. Rodriguez?
No. What do you want with Gabriel? Is he in trouble?
Stay where you are, Miss Rodriguez. We need to take a look around.
But he is not here. I have told you.
Check out the surrounds. I'll stay with the broad.
Okay.
So how far along are you, man?
Well, we got the flag here. I am kind of forced to assume that it's going to be the stolen flag.
Right.
Does look so ripped out.
I
do kind of wonder why you would have it on display like this. That's an odd font for the cover of the Bible, I would think, but... we can talk, but... I kind of want to see if there's anything else to...
Suspect vehicle from the scene. Certainly Gabriel's pride and joy.
Guess we're forced to assume that that's the Ford that the old guy saw. Can't go in there, can't go in here. We can, however, go in the kitchen with the piping teapot. Okay, I did hear the suspicious noise sound. Garish. Was it over for something on this side? I guess it might have been.
Serving breakfast for two, Anna? You should have cleared up.
So yeah, I guess he did. And I guess there isn't anything over there after all. Now what about the balcony? I guess we can go out here for a reason. This door, and guess we can't go back out here. Oh boy, can't climb up the pipe right now, though, it seems. Can't go back to the front. To assume there isn't anything important, just way out in front, though. So, but we can go into the shed. I'm guessing there's gonna be a reason for that. Oh boy.
Looks like Valdez gets his wheel back.
There's two wheels here, though. There's only one missing from the car. Have a wrench here? No, the wrench was at the crime scene, that's right. Do have a chisel. And a hammer.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
We do have a license plate that kind of stands out, though.
Diplomatic license plates.
I guess we know that they are because they're black and white. So I guess the license plate is was not taken by the dealership guy, like the accusation kind of implied, but by the kid. So there's only one room in here that I haven't checked, and that's a bedroom right here. Oh boy. La Virgen de Guadalupe. Didn't realize he was popular in Argentina. Thought it was mostly a Mexican thing. And apparently nothing else to check. Well, I guess it's time to talk now.
You're in serious trouble, Miss Rodriguez.
But Gabriel is not here. I have done nothing wrong.
Well, we do have quite a good reason to believe that.
Why did he steal the car, Anna?
Yeah, he stole the car.
The customer insulted him. He has his honor, no?
Well, the customer. Who would the customer be, though? I guess the Consul General guy? The guy who was taking bribes. Well, we know that he's around. Or that he was around very recently. But I have the feeling he's gonna have a different motive for stealing the car.
Gabriel's been in trouble before. He left you here alone to answer for him, and you expect me to believe that his motive was honor?
Please don't yell at me. I've done nothing wrong.
Is that your final answer? I guess it is. God damn it.
Tell us the truth, Anna. Has Gabriel been here?
Okay, if she lies about that, oh boy.
For at least 3 nights.
See, if she lies about that, we can nail her on that because we have the...
You keep lying to me, and I'll send you and your baby to jail.
Observation.
He lives here, but he hasn't come home. I swear it.
Well, what about the breakfast then?
Enough, Anna. There are signs all over this place that he's been back.
He was here last night. I have never seen him so angry. He went out to his shed and put some things in it. I don't know what, and I don't want to know. I love him.
Well, we guess we have to bring that up, though.
We found a license plate matching our stolen vehicle in the shed. Add in the assortment of parts, and we can make Gabriel for a dozen other thefts. It's time to get serious, Anna.
You must ask these questions of Gabriel. I know nothing of these car parts.
Well, I would be willing to believe you of that, if not for that odd facial demeanor. Well, I don't think we have anything to link her to the robbery just yet, at least. So, gonna have to go with doubt again.
Then tell us where he is! If your baby is born in prison, Anna, the corrections officers will take it from you.
Oh boy.
You see your son or daughter through a metal grate for half an hour a week.
The start line is on 1st and Santa Fe. There is a spillway under the bridge that leads to the river. Many policia have wrecked trying to follow him.
We will put in a good word for you, Anna. As far as we're concerned, this sits with Gabriel. Start line? That sounds like a street race to me. It's gotten out of hand this last year. No wonder Delgado has such an eye for fine automobiles.
Well, if he had an eye for that, then how come he didn't steal the whole thing? Oh well. So I guess we were after the kid after all. So let's see. Straight line or starting line for the street race. Why do I get the feeling we're gonna have to participate in that? Or run the track at least. With a car like this. Also, am I. Oh boy. Oh boy.
Slow down!
Well, we got out of that without any hiccups.
Pregnant girlfriends aren't always a barrel of laughs.
Racing up a bit.
Some guys wouldn't come back home at all.
Are you talking from experience?
Well, I want to say that that might be because of the OBS frame rate taking a dip, but... Oh, wait. Kids used to steal cars to sell them. Now they just want to wrap them around a lamp post. The next 16-year-old I have to peel off the sidewalk, you're calling them. I've had enough of those to last me a lifetime. Oh, Christ. Yeah, I think I'm going to go ahead and not respond to that random case. Oh boy. So there are street cars that run the electrical wires. I was wondering if that was the case. Also, I guess we might as well turn on the siren since you want to get to wherever it is we're going with some urgency. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. Right as the race is about to start. There's goodness. That's Delgado right there. Oh boy. Well, for illegal street racing is awfully organized.
Belts, 1247, requesting assistance at 1st and Santa Fe. Reports of an illegal street race.
Oh boy, what does this guy want to get in my way? Well, I'm trying, but apparently these guys are not wanting me to do that. Yes, I know, but I can't really help it there, you know.
Delgado is our boy. Forget the others.
Well, I'm trying, but they're not making it easy, you see. And especially not when this happens. Oh boy. Am I gonna lose him because of this? Because these guys are kind of in the way. And we'll not get out. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay. I'm guessing we can redo that though. Well, given the length of these cases, at least we do get some checkpoints.
Quick, they're getting away!
So it's not like GTA. We have to do the whole thing in one go all the time. Reports of an illegal street race. Okay. I'm gonna try to stay on the sidewalk now, so it doesn't give me that message about running over people on the sidewalk. Laying to the wheel arches, what?
Delgado is our boy, forget the others.
I would, but okay, this guy looks like he's out of running now, and he's not in my way, so oh, shit. But then that person got in the way. And it's kind of difficult to determine exactly where to turn on this. Oh. Okay. That isn't actually like a lake or anything where. Or a river, rather, where falling in would be really bad. Or at least I'm forced to assume that it isn't, since that guy went right in the middle and nothing happened to him. There. Oh. So this is happening. I have a feeling we're not going to take it as well as he is, being in the water like this. And, Paul, I don't know if it's just me or if it's a guy as well, but I see smoke starting to appear. Alright. Looks like we've got the car part done.
Gabriel Delgado, you're under arrest for Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck you, puto.
Oh boy.
Valdez, I shot him. Now who's a man? I should burn his fucking car.
I still don't understand why he only stole the one wheel, though.
You got a foreign dignitary outed as a fruit and kitty raper. Car dealer we're gonna let slide for kickbacks. And a street punk car thief sure as hell won't be taking liberties with other people's autos again anytime soon. That Detective Phelps is not a bad haul. You keep your chin low and your hands high, and you keep bringing me clearances just like that one. That's textbook policing, and we need more of it in this department.
Okay, I wasn't entirely certain if we actually did do a valid accusation against the consulate guy, but... I get the feeling that the ends of the chapters aren't really different depending on or no matter what we do, as long as we actually get to the end. Almost in one piece. Wasn't he nailed though for like the pedophilia thing? Why would he get the car back? Oh well. So what is after this? Another flashback.
Do you have any plans for weekend Liberty, Jack?
My sister said they're working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before Liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection. It'd better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. 2-day field drill.
Clean this rifle.
No. Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished? Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Evil people who don't want to play along in the army. Well, that looked like it could have been avoided.
I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Yeah, the bum took a swipe at me. Put him down with my son.
He's door knocking all morning. But I got a make in the car in the end.
And we can replay cases, I guess. And... there are a few DLC cases that I'm pretty sure we can access any time, even if we've never played any of the other main game parts before.
I'm going to memorize your name and throw my head away.
So what are we doing this time? Also, what time is it now? It's like, oh, it's almost 7. It's been an hour since I last checked. So I think I might do one more of these and do something else. So where are we going now? Also, I see that frame rate.
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. And Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
Why would he do time, though?
How you do that?
I'll give him something better.
I do understand why they would try to nail the kid who stole the car and was doing the races, but why nail the chick? What did she do wrong? Oh well.
Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Think as a white male named Lester Patterson walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar. Her name is Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old.
Why would it be?
Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
Why?
Take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
So, this is another fictional cop thing with Wizard of Oz references. I guess I have an affinity for those. So, what do we got?
Body traveled a good 20 feet.
Yeah, it kind of looks like it was dragged there, though. Not really. Kind of launched like you saw in the opening.
This blood is a long way from the body.
So yeah.
Going like a bat out of hell.
So this is where the impact happened, and then I'm pretty sure he didn't end up all the way over there though. I'm guessing he fell here and then someone dragged him over there. And I'll go check out the body itself, but first, what is this? The skid marks? I guess.
So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
Guess we can't really tell anything too conclusive from the tire marks. Either you with the trash in your hand cooperate with Los Angeles Clean City Scheme. I'm pretty sure that this mouse and this keyboard are gonna be quite good for another few years, so I think I'll keep them. Alright, fine.
Come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk. Well, landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind.
Well, I think he's dead. Alright. So, does he have anything in his pockets? I guess everyone has that same of a kind of in the coat kind of pocket. Mr. Patterson, we acknowledge receipt of your application for
life insurance.
Life insurance. Lump sum payout. Sum of $16,000 for your death. And he said, what the fuck? Alright. I'm guessing if this was actually him, then I don't see any reason to express that. Oh, what else does he have? He's got an address, but I'm pretty sure we got that address from the letter, so. Oh boy. And he's got a little bit of money. Guess that's all. What about the arms? Well, his arm sure is very bloody. Don't think we can learn anything too obvious from them, though. And the right arm. Or the left arm, I guess. It's right from our perspective. Well, he's kind of looks like he's got the same wounds on his hands for some reason.
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident.
Well, the same blood stains I generate.
Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest? Is that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
So he might have gotten stabbed by the hood ornament. Alright. And there's hat over here. Solidly his. And fun ourselves with the hat, I guess. Do hear LA is pretty hot. So, is there anyone else we can talk to here at the scene? I guess the woman. I guess. Oh, there we go.
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski.
So, what you see?
Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
The vehicle description.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
That seems awfully specific. But we don't really have any reason to doubt her now, do we?
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Oh boy, dropped the frames. Well, I look over to the right and it looks like it's on 60 right now.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. Man and a woman, that's all.
Man and a woman. Oh boy, she's not telling the truth on that one, is she? And we barely got any clues right now, so we can't really... prove that, but I guess we can't doubt her.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers.
Okay.
I'd like to get my picture in the paper. I'm trying to find work as an actress, and things will be pretty difficult.
Does being involved in a murder investigation help you find work as an actress, though?
Still arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
Certainly got away with.
Oh boy. Well, now the frames are way down, but now they're back to normal for a bit.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
See, even if I put it in like the ultra fast preset, then. Sometimes, most of the time it's fine, like right now it's like, oh god. It was like in the 20s and now it's in 60 according to it, but suddenly it drops down to like 8 and for a moment there it was like 1 or 2. Yeah, I don't think it likes 60 FPS is the thing. Maybe if I turn it down a bit, I don't know if I can do that without restarting the whole thing though. What if I put it at... where are the frames? At 45. Oh, okay, it can't actually do that without restarting, so hang on a minute. Let me do that real quick. Yeah, I do have it at 60, but